want to get back to our top story. We mentioned this about 45 minutes ago. A stunning new survey on illegal immigration and jobs in America. According to a Reuters review of the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics, more than 1 million immigrants, many of them illegal, found a job in the United States over the past 2 years. Now, why is that? With an employment rate at 9.4%, Congressman Lamar Smith's a Republican out of Texas, chairman of the House Judiciary Committee. And, sir, good morning to you, and thank you for
your time.
On the surface, do you believe those numbers? They seem extremely high.
Well, I do believe the numbers. They're based upon the census data and the Bureau of Labor Statistics as well. And over the last 2 years, you have 1 million jobs that have gone to foreign workers, about a third of them illegal workers. And over the same period of time, 2 million Americans have lost their jobs. And so that's the real tragedy, is you actually have a total of 26 million Americans now who are either underemployed or unemployed. And it just doesn't seem right. Those jobs should be going to American workers and not necessarily to foreign workers, many of whom are illegally employed.
A lot of these critics will argue Americans don't want these jobs, working in a hotel or cleaning up a yard. What do you think about that?
Well, first of all, there's no job that an American won't do. Even if you look at the kind of jobs where they say most of the workers are illegal, that's in agriculture, for example, 50% of those workers are, in fact, illegal immigrants or citizens. And so to say that Americans won't do those jobs is really a little bit of an insult to the Americans who do work those jobs and are, you know, any honest job is a good job. And legal workers, American citizens work every job there is, whether it's construction, whether it's waiting tables, whether it's out in the fields.
Yeah,
there are a lot of illegal
workers. If you've been unemployed for a couple of years, too, you'll do just about anything to make sure you have food on the table. Listen, I mentioned hotels, construction, sanitation, cleaning. Those are the jobs that we find this. Now, the employers have incentive to hire illegals for the following reason. They don't pay health benefits, and they don't pay basic payroll taxes. That saves the businesses money. However, there is a system that's been initiated. It's called E-Verify. Some of our viewers know about it, many do not. Now, E-Verify is a way for the employer to run a check to make sure that the employee has a Social Security number. Now, has this program, in your view, been successful?
It has been wildly successful. This E-Verify program, they check the Social Security numbers and make sure that the worker is legally in the United States and can work. 99.5% of all eligible workers do get confirmed immediately. We have 225,000 businesses that participate in the program. Another 1,300 businesses are voluntarily signing up every week. And all it is doing is allowing the employers to follow the law. And there is a law in the United States right now that says you can't hire illegal workers. So the businesses that are hiring under the table or sub wages should be, frankly, held accountable for those actions. We ought to have them use the E-Verify program, and all of those jobs should be going to American workers.
You say 1,300 businesses sign up a week for this program?
That is correct, for the E-Verify program. They want to do the right thing, they want to treat their employees right, and they also want to protect jobs for American workers.
That sounds like the best path I have heard toward reversing these numbers that we're talking about.
Exactly. Play by the rules, enforce the law, use E-Verify, keep the jobs for American workers. That is the secret to trying to reduce unemployment rate. That's the secret to putting Americans back to work.
Well, you got our attention. Lamar Smith, thank you for coming in today. Have a good weekend.
Thanks.
Okay, the Republican out of Texas in Washington.